In this video, we can discuss about the isolation techniques. So before going to the technique, let me clear one thing. What is the difference between isolation and culture? Cultural methods are used to increase the number of microorganisms of an inoculum which provided to us. We do not consider this isolation of separated colony in cultural methods. But in isolation method, we have to separate the isolated colony or specified microorganism. That is the main difference between isolation and cultural methods. Now, let's see what are the different methods. First method for the isolation technique is streak culture methods. In this, we will use an inoculating loop and we will transfer the suspension of microorganism to a fresh growth in order to attain a separated isolated colony so that it can be easily isolated and we can subculture that a single colony of microorganism. Now, second method is spread plate method. In this, we will dilute the solution to 30 to 100 cell. We will place in the center of an culture media as we mentioned in the cultural methods, and by using a bended sterile glass rod, we will spread on the entire surface, and after the incubation, we can separate the individual viable microorganism as separate colonies. Third method is pore plate culture method. So after the sufficient dilution with the nutrient agar in the liquid form, we will pour to an empty petri dish and we can isolate the separated colonies after the incubation. Now fourth method is we can isolate the microorganism by using enrichment selective indicator media, which can be used for isolation of pathogen from the specimen such as feces and with various flora. And fifth method is pre-treatment of specimen with appropriate bactericidal substances which kill the unwanted bacteria. For example, isolation of tubercle bacillus from the sputum by treatment with alkali, acid or other substances. Now coming to the sixth method, obligative aerobes as well as anaerobe can be separated by culturing under the aerobic or anaerobic conditions. So in order to isolate the aerobic microorganism, we can culture this is in an aerobic condition. So only aerobic microorganism will be isolated. For isolation of anaerobic microorganism, we have to culture this is an anaerobic condition. So only anaerobic microorganism will be isolated. So seventh method is separation of thermophiles. Thermophiles are the microorganism which will show optimum growth at 60 degrees Celsius from non-thermophilics, which is less, which will grow best in less than 60 degrees Celsius by incubating at different temperature. So only thermophile bacteria will grow at 60 degrees Celsius. Neisseria meningitidis and Neisseria catarrhalis can be separated by incubation at 20 degrees Celsius. Neisseria catarrhalis will grow only at 22 degrees Celsius because that is a non-thermophilous bacteria. Now eighth method is heating the mixture with bacteria at 80 degrees Celsius. The vegetative and spore forming can be separated. Only spore forming bacteria will grow after the 80 degrees Celsius. So it is used to isolate tetanus bacillus from other bacteria. The pathogenic bacteria can be isolated from the mixture by inoculating to appropriate animals. So example, anthrax bacillus when injected to the mice or guinea pig will produce fatal septicemia and which can be cultured pure from its heart blood. Tenth method is bacteria of different range can be isolated by means of selective filters. Filters mainly used to separating the virus from the bacteria. Next method for isolation of bacteria is by using Greig's tube. And by using this method, we can separate the motile and non-motile bacteria. Greig's tube is consist of a wide tube and a narrow tube. The both end of narrow tube is opened.
Now, semi-solid media will take in wide tube and we will keep this narrow tube in the media. Now, inoculum, which containing motile and non-motile bacteria, which is to be separated, is inoculated to the point of inoculum in the narrow tube. So, after the incubation, the motile microorganism will travel along the narrow tube and it will reach a wider tube. And the non-motile microorganism will remain in the narrow tube. So, the motile microorganism can be separated from the surface of wider tube and which can be used for the subculturing. This is mainly used to separate the non-motile as well as motile strain of Salmonella typhi. So, Salmonella typhi solution is inoculated into the narrow tube, and this narrow tube containing semi-solid media as well as the wider tube also containing semi-solid media. So, after the incubation, the motile microorganism will travel through the narrow tube and it will reaches the wider tube and it can be subcultured from the surface of wider tube.
That is all about Greig's tube.
Now, next method is rolled tube method. It can be used for the isolation of obligative anaerobe and it can be done by two methods. Let's discuss the first method. So, by using a stoppered anaerobic tube which is previously coated with pre-reduced agar medium containing oxygen-free nitrogen is used for the first method. So, whenever the stopper is removed, we have to flush oxygen-free carbon dioxide from a gas vacuola to keep the anaerobic condition. And inoculation is done by a transfer loop which held against the agar surface as the tube being rotated by a motor or by a hand. And inoculation will start from the bottom and draw the loop gradually upward. And after the inoculation, the tube is restopped and incubated anaerobically to get isolated colony. So, in first method, we will use a pre-coated tube with pre-reduced agar media on the surface and we will inoculate with a transfer loop. Now, coming to the second method, we will take the agar media with the reducing agent in an tube and we will keep flushing oxygen free carbon dioxide to maintain the anaerobic condition. To this, we will add the inoculum by using a pipette. And after adding the inoculum to the pipette, we will roll the tube under a cold water tap. So, it will solidify to get an coated with molten agar on the surface of tube. So, this is second method for roll tube method for isolation of anaerobic cultural microorganism or anaerobic microorganism. Last method is microbe manipulator method. This is a device that can pick up a single microbial cell from a colony of mixed culture and are used for conjugation with microscope. The single microbial cell is gently sucked into the micropipette and transferred onto a large drop of sterile media on another cover slip. And this can be incubated. We can separate the individual colonies. So, this is a pictorial representation. So, that is all about the isolation technique. So, these are the questions seen in the question paper. Write an essay on isolation and preservation of cultural methods. Preservation method we will discuss in next video. Write a short note on isolation method for 5 marks. So, hope it is clear. Thank you for watching this video.